Welcome to my channel. This lecture consists of 9th class mathematics and the topic is polynomials and factorizations. So before knowing regarding polynomials, I want to give you a small example to understand what are algebraic expressions. So for that I am giving you an example. So just assume there is a rectangular plot here and I placed this plot with some plates like this, plates in some rows. So I will assume that the number of rows and the number of plates in each row be x. That is, the number of rows be x and the number of plates in each row be x. So can you tell me how many number of plates are there in this plot? We can get that number by multiplying this rows into number of plates in each row. So that is x square. So multiplying this number of rows x with the number of plates in each row x, we will get total number of plates as x square. Similarly, there is a bunch of a pack which is consisting of some pack of biscuits here. So let the price of each biscuit packet be 6 rupees, and there are x biscuit packets in this box. So can you give me what is the total number of total price of this pack? We get that price of the pack by multiplying the 6 rupees with total number of biscuit packets. So we assume that the number of biscuit packets be x. So the total price will be 6 into x. So such a type of expressions we meet daily, we call them as algebraic expressions. So now coming to polynomials. So what is a polynomial? A polynomial is an expression consisting of variables. These we call them as variables. So a polynomial is an expression consisting of variables and coefficients, and that involves only the operations of additions, subtractions, multiplications, and finally non-negative integer components of variables. So non-negative means only positive integers, where only the exponents, non-negative exponents and integer exponents. So what are integers? What are non-negative integers? Plus 1, plus 2, plus 3, plus 4, so on. So if there is 1 by 2 here, we don't call it as a polynomial. It is not a polynomial. And if there is some negative power here, then also we don't call it as a polynomial. So finally, I will give you some examples. So these are some examples of some quadratic some algebraic expressions. So from this, I will differentiate whether it is a polynomial or not. So first one is x square. So it is a it consisting of some variables, and the variable has an exponent, and the exponent is a non-negative integer also. Non-negative integer. So definitely it is a polynomial. Coming to the second one, the question is 2x square minus 3 by x plus 5. So finally this can be written as 2x square minus 3 into this 1 by x can be written as into x to the power of minus 1. So since here 2x square is a perfect polynomial if there is no 3 by x here. But in this term, the x is having a power of minus 1, which is a negative integer. So since it is consisting of a negative integer, it doesn't come under a polynomial. Similarly, the third one is also a polynomial since it is having only variables and powers as only non-negative integer components. And now coming to the final one, the question here is x power of 1 by 2 plus 3. So this one is not having any non-negative integer, but it is this 1 by 2 is not an integer. This is some rational number. So this is also doesn't come under polynomial. So I think you guys got a clear picture of what is a polynomial. So now I think you can differentiate whether it is a polynomial or not. So finally, I want to again give you a clear picture of this polynomial. An algebraic expression in which the variables involved have only non-negative integer powers, we call it as a polynomial. Simply, an algebraic expression in which the variables have only the powers of non-negative integers, then we call them as polynomials. Now the next topic is degree of the polynomial. So before learning about the degree of the polynomial, we should learn regarding the degree of the term. So here in this example, particular example, the example is 3x square y square plus 4xy plus 7. So in this one, this particular, this 3x square y square is a term, 4xy is a term, and 7 is a term. So we call them as terms. So what is the degree of a term? The degree of a term is the sum of exponent of its variable factors. So it has some variables, each term has some variables, and it and each variable has some exponents. So sum of these exponents, we call them as degree of a term. So for this particular example, the degree of the term 3x square y square is x power of 2 y power of 2. So 2 plus 2, that is 4 is the degree of this term 3x square y square. And coming to this term 4xy, the degree of this term is 1 plus 1, x power of 1 and y power of 1. So 1 plus 1, 2 is the degree of this term. So now what is the degree of polynomial? So, and degree of the polynomial is the largest degree of its variable term. So we can now calculate the degree of each term individually. So for each term we had calculated some degree. Now the largest of all these terms, largest degree of all these terms, we call it as a degree of a polynomial. So for this example, 3x square plus 7x plus 2, the first term has a degree of 2 and the second term has a degree of 1, and the third term has a degree of 0, because this 5 can be written as 5 into x to the power of 0. So it has a degree of 0. So finally, what is the degree of this polynomial? Since this is the largest degree of in all these terms, 2 is the degree of the polynomial. And coming to this 3x square y square plus 4xy plus 7, the degree of this polynomial is 4, since this term has largest degree compared to other terms. So now, after the degree of the polynomial, the next topic is coefficient of the polynomial. So a coefficient is a multiplicative factor in some term of a polynomial. So this coefficient varies with respect to terms. So if we need a coefficient of x square in a polynomial, the coefficient will be 3 here. If we need the coefficient of x square here, it will be 3. But for the same polynomial, if we need a coefficient of x, it will be 7. So I think you got what is coefficient. The coefficient is a multiplicative factor. The multiplicative factor in before the term, we call it as a coefficient of the particular term of polynomial. So now coming to the problematic part, the first question is find the degree of each of the polynomials given below. So I think you can identify them easily. The first term, first question has three terms, x power of 5, x power of 4, and 3. So the first term has a degree of 5, and the second term has a degree of 4, and the third term has a degree of 0. So finally, the degree of polynomial is the greater of the term, degrees of each term. So greater of 5, 4, and 0 is 5. So degree of this polynomial is 5. And coming to the second question, 4 minus y square. So it has two terms. The first term has a degree of 0, and the second term has a degree of 2. So from both 2 and 0, 2 is a greater 1, so the degree of this polynomial is 2. Now coming to the second question, which of the following expressions are polynomials in one variables and which are not? So the question here is to identify the polynomials in one variable. So previously you know how to identify a polynomial, but the difference from that examples to this question is you should identify a polynomial in one variable. So what is the difference? I will explain to you. The first question is 3x square minus 2x plus 5. So definitely it is a polynomial since there is no negative integers, negative and rational numbers. It is having only non-negative integer powers in exponents in this format in algebraic expression. So this is a perfectly polynomial. Coming to the second one, this is also a polynomial. This is also a polynomial since it is only having non-negative integer powers. But the third one is not at all a polynomial since it is having one negative power, because this 2 by y can be written as 2 into y to the power of minus 1. So it is having a power of minus 1. So this algebraic expression is not a polynomial. But the question here is polynomial in one variable. So again, I am explaining these two. This is, I omitted this since it is not at all a polynomial. Coming to the questions 1 and 2. The first one, first question consists of only one variable, that is x square, x and x power 0 something. And so it is a polynomial of one variable. But coming to the second question, it has two variables, x and y. So this is not a polynomial of one variable. This is is not a polynomial of one variable since it is having, this is a polynomial, but it is not a polynomial of one variable since it is having two variables here. So that is the difference between identifying a polynomial and identifying a polynomial with one variable or some other variables. Now, third question is, write the coefficients of x power 3 in each of the following cases. So the multiplicative factor that exists before this x power 3 is the coefficient. So in the first question, the x power 3 is having a multiplicative factor of minus 1. So the coefficient of x power 3 in this question is minus 1. Coming to the second question, the multiplicative factor here for x power 3 is pi by 2. So the coefficient of x power 3 in this question is pi by 2. Now coming to the next question, classify the following as linear, quadratic and cubical polynomials. So I want you to explain what is the difference between linear, quadratic and cubical polynomials with this example. So what is a linear polynomial? You know how to identify the degree of a polynomial. So if the degree of the polynomial is 1, we call it as a linear polynomial. And if the degree of a polynomial is 2, we call it as a quadratic polynomial. And if the degree of a polynomial is 3, we call it as a cubical polynomial. Simple. So the first question consists of a degree 2. Since it is of highest degree, this term is of highest degree 2. So the degree of this polynomial is 2. So since this is having a degree of 2, we call it as a quadratic polynomial. And coming to the second question, the degree of this polynomial is 1. So it is a linear polynomial. And coming to third question, the degree here is that for this term the degree is 1 and for this term the degree is 3. So the highest degree will be the degree of the polynomial, that is 3. So since the degree of this polynomial is 3, it is a cubical polynomial. So this is regarding polynomials, and these problems are from first exercise. So coming to the next lecture, I am going to explain you the zeros of a polynomial. What are the zeros of a polynomial? How to find out these zeros of a polynomial? So please like, comment and share and subscribe for more videos.